Hello and welcome to exam study. Today we will discuss about the battles that British fought with the Indian rulers and the other European powers to establish their supremacy. The main objective of Britishers in the starting was only to have trade in India. The objective of imperialism was developed later on. At that time, Bengal was a very rich province. So if Britishers want to capture India, then they have to capture Bengal. That they have understood. So that by that, the Battle of Plassey was fought, and this established the British supremacy over India. Started because there were many small kingdoms, and time by time Britishers has to cede each of them to establish their supremacy over the whole of the country. So they started it from Bengal and fought Battle of Plassey under Lord Clive in 1757. The date was 23rd June 1757. It was fought between the British forces and the Nawab of Bengal. And Nawab of Bengal was betrayed by Mir Jafar, Manik Chand, Ami Chand, Jagat Seth. All these betrayed Nawab. They conspire with the Britishers against the Nawab. So as a result, Nawab was defeated in the war. And now conquest of Bengal was started. They portions were under British. So after that, many more wars were fought to establish their supremacy. Presently, Plassey is in West Bengal, Nadia district, on the banks of river Bhagirathi. So the date is important, please note it down, and between which it was fought, British East India Company over the Nawab of Bengal and the Nawab of Bengal, or territorial changes the Bengal annexed by the British East India Company. Remember, not whole of India, only Bengal was annexed. Where it is on the banks of river Bhagirathi in Nadia district, West Bengal. So next was the Battle of Wandiwash. Battle of Wandiwash, this is fought between Britishers and the French, and the main objective was to root out the French, and British established their supremacy. So the what's important, the Count de Lally, he was the Governor General of the French Army. Sir Eyre Coote, he was the Governor General of the English British Army, and as a result, Sir Eyre Coote's forces defeated Count de Lally's army. So in this war, Britishers won the battle defeating French, and the French were restricted only to Pondicherry. And where this Wandiwash lies, it is in the state of Tamil Nadu presently. Next battle that Britishers fought was the, sorry, this was not of Britishers, third battle of Panipat was fought between the Marathas and Shah Abdali, Afghan king. And in this battle, Marathas were defeated, and Ahmed Shah Abdali was supported by Indian allies Rohila Najibullah, Afghan of the Duab, and Shujadullah, jo Awadh ke nawab the. In dono ne usko support kiya tha, aur iske Marathas se unko support nahi mil paya tha local kings and rulers ka, to is wale battle mein haar gaye the. This was not fought between by the Britishers, it was fought between Marathas and Ahmed Shah Abdali. Next, Britishers fought in 1764, the Battle of Buxar. Battle of Buxar, because after Battle of Plassey, Mir the Nawab was dethroned from the throne. His son-in-law was Mir the Nawab by Britishers, but that was a puppet Nawab. So Mir the Battle of Buxar was fought between the Britishers and the combined army of Mir Qasim, who was the Bengal of Nawab till 1763, Nawab of Awadh, and the Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II, because Shah Alam was ruling from Delhi, but he also has a fear that someday British may conquest Delhi, the region around Delhi. So these were the forces who fought the Battle of Buxar, the Britishers on one side and the combined army of Mir Qasim, Nawab of Bengal till 1763, Nawab of Awadh or Mughal Empress Shah Alam. See what happens when initially Nawab of Bengal was dethroned after the Battle of Plassey, and his son-in-law Mir Qasim was made Mughal of Nawab of Bengal. He was a puppet ruler. So he ruled till 1763. After that, Britishers made the original Nawab as Nawab of Bengal. So this triggered the Mir Qasim. And he, by getting help from the Nawab of Awadh and the Mughal Empress Shah Alam, they fought the battle against Britishers. However, they all were defeated by Britishers. Britishers won, and Shujaudullah and Shah Alam. Shujaudullah was the Nawab of Awadh, and Shah Alam was the Mughal Emperor. They surrendered, and war came to an end by signing a Treaty of Allahabad in 1765. Next was to after the conquest of Bengal, the next turn was of Mysore. So in that chapter, four wars were fought with the ruler of Mysore. Hyder Ali was first. After that, Tipu Sultan succeeded him. So the wars were first Anglo-Mysore wars. Remember, wherever you are found Anglo, that means one side is Britishers, and the other Anglo-Mysore war, the fought between Mysore and Britishers. The first Anglo-Mysore war was fought between 1767 to 1769. Governor General was Verus. War ended by Treaty of Madras. It was fought between the army of Hyder Ali, the father of Tipu Sultan, and the Britishers. After that, second Mysore war happens in 1780 to 1784. Governor General was Warren Hastings. This war was ended by signing a Treaty of Mangalore, and in this war Hyder Ali was died. Third Anglo-Mysore war was fought by Tipu Sultan, who was the successor of Hyder Ali, in 1790 to 1792. Governor General was Lord Carnarvonis, and the war came to an end after signing Treaty of Srirangapatnam. The last war was the fourth Anglo-Mysore war. It was in 1799. Tipu Sultan was defeated and killed during the battle, and the Governor General was Lord Wellesley. So Tipu Sultan was killed, and as a result the supremacy of British over the Mysore kingdom was established. The kingdom of Mysore came into the prominence of British. So two big kingdoms, the Bengal and Mysore, now they are in under Britishers. Now the next target of Britishers was Marathas, because Maratha territory was a vast one. With Marathas they fought three wars only. First war was fought in 1775 to 1782, and the war ended with the Treaty of Salbai. In first war, Marathas were victorious. In the second, Britishers were victorious. Treaty of Rajghat was signed. Third Anglo-Maratha war, isi war ko hum log Pindari war ke naam se bhi jante hain. This is a victory Britishers ki hui, aur yahan par formally Maratha Empire ka end ho gaya. Though Marathas, as a result, Maratha Empire was under the British rule by that time, 1818. The next, the Battle of Kharda. Battle of Kharda was not fought between Britishers, but it was fought between the Nizam and the Maratha Empire. Nizam of Hyderabad and Maratha Empire. So ye ek last battle tha jo sare Maratha chiefs ne milke lada tha. Iska result raha tha ki Maratha was victorious, aur jo Nizam tha kuch territory cede kar di, aur ye is pe bhi razi ho gaya ki कुछ पैसे एनुअली मराठा किंगडम को प्रोवाइड कराएगा. बैटल ऑफ चिलियांवाला. बैटल ऑफ चिलियांवाला जो था वो सिख
पंजाब रीजन में हुआ था. इट वॉज फॉट इन 1849 ड्यूरिंग सेकेंड एंग्लो सिख वॉर, जो ब्रिटिशर्स का सिख के साथ में होता. हाउ एवर ब्रिटिशर्स ओनली फॉट टू वॉर्स विद सिख एंड बाय द एंड ऑफ द सेकेंड एंग्लो सिख वॉर द पंजाब स्टेट वॉज एनेक्स टू द ब्रिटिश एम्पायर. Presently, this is a region in modern Pakistan. It was undecisive. After the Second Anglo-Mysore War, the Punjab state was annexed in the British Empire. So these were the major war that were fought by the Britishers with the Indian rulers and other European powers. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.